has been a champion for the world's oceans and marine life in an era when sharks were feared and hunted relentlessly. Taylor fought for their protection. Now she's taking on an epic new challenge, pairing up with the inaugural Youth Ocean Carnival to encourage Gen Zers to get active in conservation. Please welcome Valerie Taylor and Olympic. Thanks so much for being with us. Valerie, you've spent so much of your life championing the oceans. How bad are things?
The oceans are in a terrible condition compared to what they were when I was young, when I first started, when I first went diving in 1956, long time ago. And the sad thing is that the young people today will never, ever see what I took for granted. And I'd like to say to everybody out there, we've got to teach the young people. They'll think that it's exactly correct as it starts today, because that's all they'll know. And that's possibly all they'll ever know. But it's important that they maintain what is left. It's important for the future of the planet.
You've devoted your entire life to the benefit of the oceans.
Yes.
How does that make you feel when you see it in such a state of disrepair?
Makes me feel very fortunate that I'm so old. I was there, I was the first. In many places, my husband and I were the first. And we saw how nature had made it. I don't know where you could really go today and see what I saw. It no longer exists.
Well, thankfully, you've got young people like the wonderful Sam Fricker on your
team. Sam tells me he's a diver.
Different kind, though.
Sam, tell us about the carnival and what you're hoping to achieve with it.
Yeah, so we came up with the carnival idea when I was accepted onto the World Ocean Day Youth Advisory Council, which was just right off the back of the Olympics. And we were thinking about what we can do to have an impact. Now, when I was in school, I started Sam Straws, which is the biodegradable straw company. And I thought, it's young people who have the energy and the power to make an impact, and they'll be such a large part of the population moving forward. And education is such an important part of that, knowing how to make a change. So the idea is to bring all these young people together, have events around Sydney on World Ocean Day, the 8th, and just educate people on how they can have an impact. Because I find a lot of young people want to try and do the right thing. They want to have an impact, but they just don't know how. And I think just educating people about, you know, even the choices you make, or starting a small business, or even, you know, making videos like I do as well on social media to educate others, it all has an impact, and that's really what it's all about.
Well, sharks are an important part, obviously, of the ocean and something you've worked long and hard on, Valerie. And you've also worked on the Jaws movie, which was really the genesis of most people's fear of sharks. Do you wish that that maybe they'd made Jaws a little nicer and that would have helped the cause?
Jaws is a fictitious story about a fictitious shark. And Peter Benchley never dreamt that people would take it seriously, and neither did Ron and Valerie Taylor. We were all horrified. And we went to Martha's Vineyard for the shoot. We weren't allowed to work there, but they were very kindly took us. And everybody we spoke to thought sharks were terrible, terrifying, and huge. And I said, oh, there's all sorts of over 300 species, and a lot of them are just little. But we were shocked at the impact that film had on the minds of the general public, particularly the public that likes swimming off beaches. And it's not like that at all.
If the sharks need a bit of a rebranding, have you seen the progress shark in Sydney that's been dressed up for World Pride there in the,
there
in the
it
rainbow?
Is. People are loving it.
That's.
Oh. What do you make of that?
Oh, well, it's very scary.
obviously, educating young people about what has disappeared is going to be difficult because they can't see it in the way that Valerie did. How are you planning to engage young people with that?
It's a very good point. And it wasn't until the other day when Valerie spoke about how we as young people don't even understand what it was like back then. We don't even know what we're missing out. And I suppose it comes back to what you don't know, you don't know. I never even really thought about that, but it's such a good point. And I think all we can really do is do our best to protect it from here on out and then try and reverse what is done. And I know that maybe we might not be able to get back there, but I think it's definitely worth doing everything we can to stop and then try and reverse what's already been done.
Obviously, you both do different types of diving, very different types of diving. Sam, have you ever thought about sort of including sharks in the Olympic pool to sort of make it an extreme sport of sorts?
Well, you know what? It's definitely not extreme enough. Just standing up. You'd know things with your backflip you did a few years ago.
That's very bad.
You know, I think diving's challenging enough as is. Put some sharks in the water, I'd probably still send it, just hope for the best.
Would you jump off the board, Valerie?
No.
We'll try each other's diving.
Valerie, you've been bitten by four different sharks, that's right, in your life.
Well, they were different sharks, yes.
But that terrifies you, jumping off the high board.
I can't swim.
You kept that quiet. Are you joking?
I never learned.
Wow.
Well,
you got floaties in your scuba gear?
Oh, they all came after the war.
Well, Youth Ocean Carnival will take place in Sydney this June, and you can find all the details on our website. Please thank Valerie and Zach.